she had the most beautiful smile. And her eyes, you could just see that, you know, they just lit up. I don't give anything to see her smile again.
It's been more than 21 months since Jenny Jimenez has seen or heard from her daughter, Emily Hieber.
She was really funny. She loved telling jokes. She was very, very smart, very talented, very beautiful. She always had everybody laughing.
Jimenez says her daughter did well in school and was part of the swim team.
Her grades were always really good. Junior high, elementary school, high school. High school was kind of up and down, just like I think any kid probably is, but her junior year was amazing. She was getting amazing grades. And swimming was phenomenal. She was right there.
But she says everything changed the summer before Emily's senior year.
Things were happening in the house that, you know, that in the home that shouldn't be happening. And I was finding things I shouldn't be finding. And
what are some of these things? What kind of drugs was she doing? Was she doing drugs, smoking? What was she doing?
Just marijuana. That's the only thing I found here. And smoking, yeah, she was smoking.
She would always talk about not wanting to do that anymore. She didn't want to do drugs anymore. She didn't want to be in that life anymore. She talked a lot about getting out of it.
Then on February 3rd, 2013, Emily posted what would be her last Facebook update.
We left message after message after message after message.
Back in March 22nd, we began an investigation on a missing person, Emily Lynn Hieber, who is 19 years of age.
At the beginning of the case, we didn't have much information on whom Emily was associating with. We knew that she was involved into meth, and so she was into the meth world. And we've heard a lot of rumors that Emily has been murdered for various different reasons. But the rumor is pretty strong that she had been murdered, and that's why we're actively working this investigation.
Investigators have conducted dozens of interviews and have followed leads in Arizona, California, and Mexico, but still no sign of Emily.
We have worked with law enforcement agencies from the other side of the border. We're still investigating it.
Leon Worthen with the Yuma Police Department says investigators continue to search for answers.
It's a process, but you don't give up hope. And our detectives are engaged, and we are engaged in this as a community.
For close to 2 years, the family has posted flyers like this one and billboards like the one right behind me all over Yuma County. They are now offering a $15,000 reward for any information that leads them directly back to Emily.
Help us. We need to find her. She's, you know, we're missing a big part of this family. You know, I just want to know where she is. I need to know where she is. I want to hear her go, you know, hi, Mom. That's what I hear in my head all the time, is her voice. And that's what I want to hear, is her, just hi, Mom.